check the custom tray created by the dental lab. Make sure that there is enough space to accommodate the lip and the cheek frenulum. When the patient closes her mouth, make sure that the bite plates close in a parallel and flat position. The patient should not feel any pain in the process. To shape the functional margin in the upper jaw, thoroughly rinse the tray and dry it. Apply a suitable adhesive around its circumference. On the prepared margins, apply virtual heavy body and carefully rotate the impression tray into the mouth. Ask the patient to suck on your finger once or twice and to move the lower jaw to the right and to the left. This activates the muscles. Next, insert the tray in the lower jaw. Ask the patient to close her mouth. While the patient lightly bites on the bite plates, she is asked to make certain functional movements. She alternates between pursing the lips and smiling. These movements should be repeated 8 to 10 times. Subsequently, the jaw should remain closed while the material sets completely. Trim the material pressed on the inner surface of the tray back to 2 mm. Excess in the dorsal area should also be removed. After having coated the inner surface of the tray with adhesive varnish, apply virtual light body for the basic or wash impression. Insert the tray and lightly press it into place. It's important to remove any excess that is pressed out on the dorsal aspect immediately. Ask the patient to suck on your finger again. This allows you to determine if impression material is still flowing towards the throat. If this is the case, remove it. The next steps are carried out in the same way as those for taking the impression of the functional margin. Small voids and inaccuracies can be corrected with a virtual extra light body. For this purpose, proceed in the usual way. When the tray is removed, you should be able to feel the suction effect. All the important anatomical details should be visible without any voids. Excess material must be removed, particularly in the area of the tuberosities. The functional impression of the lower jaw is taken in the same way as that of the upper jaw. The only difference is that instead of having the patient suck on a finger, she is asked to stick out her tongue and move it to the left and to the right a few times, touching the upper lip. Insert the upper impression and ask the patient to carry out the functional movements with her mouth closed. Between the individual functional movements, ask the patient to swallow. This process is always the same, shaping the functional margin with virtual heavy body, taking a wash impression with virtual light body, and any necessary adjustments with virtual extra light body. Remove any excess in the area of the retromolar pads in particular. This will ensure smooth movements at a later stage. Check the stability and suction of the impression. When the jaws are closed, the bite plates should be positioned flat on top of each other. By testing the patient's speech, check the vertical dimension and then make any necessary adjustments. Ask the patient to say words such as 66 or Mississippi, or have them count from 60 to 70. If the vertical dimension is too high, the bite rims will touch each other when the patient speaks. In this case, remove one of the rims and test the situation again. If the vertical dimension is too low, you can increase it in millimeters with wax plates. The renewed determination of the physiologic resting position is also possible at this stage. Any corrections that are necessary can be transferred to the stylus of the Anathometer M. Check whether the setup is parallel to the camper's plane and bipupillary line using an occlusal plane plate. To prepare for the registration, remove the white bite plates. Adjust the vertical dimensions if necessary by rotating the screw. One rotation corresponds to 1 mm. Secure the adjusted screw with some wax. Attach the registration plate with the stylus to the lower impression. Use forceps for this purpose. Proceed in the same way in the upper jaw. Use a wax crayon and Bunsen burner to color the registration plate. Make sure to cool the plate thoroughly with water after coloring it. Inform the patient about the possible risk of injury before you insert the two impressions together with the mounted gnathometer CAD. The patient's tongue must not enter the space between the plates. The patient carries out protrusive and laterotrusive movements to the left and to the right. You can guide the patient by indicating the direction of the lower jaw movements with your finger. The movements should be repeated 3 times in each case. When the direction is changed, the patient opens her mouth, swallows, and then closes her mouth again. When a clear arrowhead or Gothic arch is visible, remove the bite plate from the upper jaw to record this position. If this is not the case, the tracing procedure has to be repeated. Mark the tip of the arrow with a permanent marker and record the position with the perforated plexiglass plate. In order to verify this position, ask the patient to find the centric position herself several times in a row. Subsequently, this situation is recorded with virtual CAD bite. You can now mark the midline and, if necessary, other referencing lines for the dental technician. Optionally, you can use the 3D universal transfer bow for skull-related model orientation. Attach it directly to the gnathometer M by means of the 3D joint. The form selector helps you to choose the appropriate teeth. The integrated facial meter is used to determine the width of the nose. This information provides a reference for the size of the teeth. Together with the patient, you can now select the desired tooth shape and shade. It's also important to find out from the patient if they would like the anterior teeth to have a straight, natural, or individualized position. Subsequently, send all the information you have collected to the dental laboratory.